الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما صدق الله العظيم أما بعد all praises are due to Allah we thank him we praise him we believe in him and we testify that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is his handpicked messenger who has been sent for the success of man in this life and the life hereafter. May the peace, mercy, and blessing of Allah be upon Rasulullah, his family, and whoever follows him towards righteousness until the day of Qiyamah. Amma ba'd. Today's khutbah is on the importance and benefits of prayers. In other words, salah. The importance of salah and the benefits of performing salah with sincerity and devotion only to please Allah. Prayer is the second most important pillar in Islam after the shahada. Prayer is the most important after the shahada from the five pillars of Islam. And it is the most regularly compulsory action that is performed on a daily basis by a Muslim. However, It is the one act that must be fulfilled at least 5 times a day, regardless to what circumstance we have. Even if the individual, and the Muslim for that matter, is on his deathbed in Sukurat and it's time for prayers, once he is conscious, he can still perform Salah, whatever circumstance. Looking at the other pillars of Islam, there are exceptions to the rule. When it comes to fasting, there is an exception. And there is a time for fasting. When it comes to zakah, you only give out zakah if you fulfill the criteria. When it comes to performing hajj, you perform hajj if you have the means and help to do so. But as far as salah is concerned, under whatever circumstance you find yourself, there is always the need to perform salah on time with sincerity and devotion. Besides, success in this life lies in salah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam narrated in an authentic narration. He said, the first thing which will be judged among a man's deed on the day of resurrection is the prayer. If this is good, then everything will be good. But if it is defective, then he will fail and he will be a loser. The first thing to be accounted for when we stand before Allah is salah. If salah is okay, then everything will be okay. Everything will follow suit. But if at all salah is found wanting, then the individual becomes a loser. We will lose in this life, of course, and in the life hereafter, nothing will work out for us if at all the salah is found wanting. No wonder the Prophet encouraged us to be performing optional prayers after salah. After the 5 daily prayers, the optional prayers before and after will patch out whatever difference there is when we stand before Allah. If at all the salah is found wanting, Allah will say, check, go and have a look at his optional prayers and patch the difference. But that optional prayers cannot patch that which is missed. Like after missing salah, intentionally saying, I'm not going to pray an obligatory prayer. An optional prayer cannot make up for that one. أَوْقَمَا كَالَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ Through prayer, you are able to connect to your Lord. If we want to connect to Allah, it is only through salah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when any one of you stands to pray, he is communicating with his Lord. So let him pay attention as to how to speak to him. He said, let him pay attention as to how to speak to his Lord. Don't cut the relationship between you and your Lord. Again, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Allah azza wa jalla said in Hadith Qudsi that I have divided prayer between myself and my servant into 2 halves. Allah said, I have divided salah between me and my servant into 2 halves. In other words, 1 half is for Allah and the other half is for the servant. The other half is for you, standing in front of Allah performing the salah. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla went on to say, and my servant shall have whatever he asks for. When we perform our salah with sincerity and devotion, Allah has promised that my servant will have whatever he asks for. When the servant says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, then Allah Azza wa Jalla will respond by saying, my servant has praised me. Anytime you stand in prayer, during the 5 daily prayers, when you say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, all praises are due to Allah, Lord of the Alam, mankind and everything that exists, Allah will respond by saying, my servant has praised me. When he says, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most gracious, the most merciful, Allah will say, my servant has exalted me. When the servant says, Maliki Yawmiddin, master of the day of judgment, Allah will say, my servant has glorified me and my servant has submitted to me. When the servant says, you alone we worship and you alone we ask for help, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ, you alone, no one. You alone we worship, and you alone we ask for help. Allah will respond by saying, this is between me and my servant, and my servant will have whatever he asks for. Then when the servant says, guide us to the straight path, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. When the servant says, guide us to the straight path, the path of those whom you have favored. Who are the ones that are favored by Allah? They are the messengers. They are the righteous ones. These are the ones who are truthful in words and deeds. These are the people that are favored. How do we know this? It is Allah who told us in the Quran that this particular group is the favored one. وَمَنْ يُطِئِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. Whoever keeps his duty to Allah and his Rasul, فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. Those will enjoy the companionship of those upon whom Allah has favored. مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. So when we stand and say to Allah, اِهْدِنَ الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ, the path of those whom you have favored, we are referring to the enbiya and the prophets. We are referring to the messengers. We are referring to the righteous. We are referring to those who are true in words and deeds. صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ. Not of those who earn your anger. عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِينَ. And not of those who have gone astray. After saying this, صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِينَ. Then Allah will respond by saying, this is for my servant, and my servant will have whatever he asks for. This is the prayers that we make each time we recite Fatiha in every prayer. Imagine doing this every day, 5 times a day. In each unit of prayer, there is the hope and belief that inshallah, the individual will have his dua accepted so long as he is sincerely asking Allah without associating partners with him. Just as the body requires physical needs such as food and water, we need food and water in order to survive, bi-iznillah. Imagine an individual who has not eaten anything for 1 month and he didn't drink anything for 1 month. If he's lucky, he will still be alive. And if he is alive, you would see the impression in him. Why? Because the body needs food and water. But then again, there is something that feeds the soul, which is neither food nor water. That which feeds the soul is the word of Allah, is the glorification of Allah, is the worship of Allah, is being servitude to Allah. The body is made of what? مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. So we need food, we need water in order to survive. But then again, if an individual dies, the soul returns to the owner, and that's Allah. يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةِ ارْجِئِي إِلَىٰ رَبِّكِ رَاضِيَةً مَرْضِيَّةً فَدُخُلِي فِي عِبَادِي وَدُخُلِي جَنَّتِي. This is the soul of the righteous person that is being addressed at the time of death. يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةِ. O you with the good heart, with the heart full of satisfaction, with the heart full of tranquility, ارْجِئِي إِلَىٰ رَبِّكِ. Come back or return to your Lord. Radiyatan mardiyya, well pleased and well pleasing. Because the soul is from Allah. So that which gives life to the soul is the word of Allah and the ibadah of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Now the needs of the soul are provided by acts of worship. And the most important act of worship is salah. It could be that the body of a person is healthy, but this person is spiritually dead. You can see the individual who looks really healthy, because he is eating good food, drinking, he has a balanced diet. So you can see that on the outside and you will be impressed. But spiritually he is dead. He is feeding his body,
But the soul is not being fed. The soul is starving. There is no connection with Allah. No wonder the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam narrated in a hadith that the comparison of the one who remembers Allah and the one who does not remember Allah is like the living and the dead. Digante kuy sabbal yalla di fatel ko yalla akuko du def dafa melni ku dunda akude momin kamari man satalla to finko akamari man satalla batu aka qur'ano karan ani momi yalon ka buko woke itemo buko le sure wonim baluo momin be baluo la ani momin fata wolfulonten kilinki ni ben neew bo layta bondi la fure konton wato sita fure anan konton wo buko foje. So those who remember Allah and those who don't remember Allah, the Prophet said there are differences like the living and the dead. And Allah said in the Quran, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu istajibu lillahi wa rasul idha da'akum lima yuhyikum. Allah said, O you who believe, respond to the call of Allah and His messenger when He calls you to that which gives you life. Ibadah gives you life, spiritual life. So Allah said we should respond. No wonder it is said in the Quran, إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ فَسَعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعَ ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ تَعَلَمُونَ. If a proclamation is being made on the day of Jum'ah, فَسَعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, rush to the remembrance of Allah and leave what bay'ah, buying and selling. Whatever engagement you have, as far as dunya is concerned, when it's time for salah, on the day of Friday, leave everything. Because, ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. That is better for you if you know. And Allah is saying, فَإِذَا قُدِيَتِ الصَّلَاةِ. Once the salah is over, فَانْتَسِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Disperse on the face of this earth. فَانْتَسِرُوا. And seek the favors of Allah. وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Meanwhile, making zikrullah as much as you can so that you will be successful. So Allah said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَجِيبُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلرَّسُولِ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ. All you who have iman, all you who believe in Allah, respond to the call of Allah and His messenger when He calls you to that which gives you life. Again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam narrated that the covenant between us and them is prayer. So if anyone abandons prayer, he has become a disbeliever. In another narration, بين المسلم والكافر ترك الصلاة. Between a Muslim and a disbeliever is the leaving of salah. Whoever decides not to pray again because he doesn't think it's a requirement of Islam, then the Prophet said you've gone outside the fold of Islam. Now let's consider for a moment Shaytan, who was a jinn, not even an angel. Allah said, kana min al-jinn fa fasaq. He obeyed Allah, he worshipped Allah for a very long time. But when he was asked to prostrate for Adam, out of respect, not even putting the forehead on the ground, he denied. Then Allah said to him, innaka rajim, you are rejected. Itemu berla bum fenneti. Just by failing to prostrate once, how many prostrations are in salah then? Salatul Fajr, how many prostrations? Salatul Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. How many prostrations? And each is an obligation. Satan rejected to prostrate for man just once, and Allah destroyed all his actions. How many prostrations are in Salah? Salah is a direct communication with Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the closest a person is to his Lord is when he is in prostration. The closest the individual is to Allah is when he is in sujood. Every act of worship was given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam through an intermediary, an angel for that matter. But with salah, he went up to meet Allah to be given 50 daily prayers, only to be cut down to 5. But inna Allah la yukhliful mi'ad. Allah never fails His promise. If we perform the 5 daily prayers with sincerity and devotion, we will have the original reward of performing salah 50 times a day. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الذي نصر الدين وأحب المساكين وكفل اليتيم وهدى إلى صراط مستقيم. أما بعد, what are some of the benefits and importance of salah in this life and the life hereafter? Among them is, it is a shield against evil. When one performs salah, eventually that salah keeps you away from committing sin, and it purifies you so that in the eyes of Allah you will be among the good servants. Man was created with weakness, and without seeking help from Allah, it will be impossible to refrain from evil. No wonder someone asked the Prophet, what's the meaning of la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah? There is no might and no power except from Allah. The response was, no one has the power and the might to keep away from evil until and unless he is helped and assisted by Allah. And no one has the might and power to do any act of good without the help of Allah. So we need Allah's help all the time in order to keep away from evil. Allah says in the Quran, "Inna salata tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar," that verily prayers restrains oneself from shameful and unjust deeds. There is no doubt that one who stands in front of Allah willingly 5 times a day, performing salah with sincerity and devotion, there is hope that Allah Azza wa Jalla will forgive his sins, inshallah. And again, another benefit of salah is it enriches the soul. Man is forgetful, especially with our busy lifestyles. We are forgetful. We forget on a regular basis. Prayer satisfies our spiritual need to be in contact with our Allah Azza wa Jalla all the time. This gives the soul the peace and contentment. No wonder Allah said in the Quran, verily in the remembrance of Allah does the heart find rest. Are you stressed? And you want a stress-free life? Allah said, turn to the remembrance of Allah. Ala bi dhikri Allahi tatma'innul qulub. Is it not in the remembrance of Allah that the heart gets its satisfaction? And when you say salah starts with takbiratul ihram, Allahu Akbar, and it finishes with the first salam. But throughout salah, everything is the remembrance of Allah. No wonder Allah said to Musa alayhi salam, wa aqimis salata li dhikri, and establish salah for my remembrance. And Allah said, ala bi dhikri Allahi tatma'innul qulub. Again, salah leads to piety, God consciousness. Umar asked Habab, what is piety? He said, have you traversed or walked through a pathway with thorny bushes? He said, yes. Then Habab asked him, how did you manage? He said, I held my clothing together and walked carefully until I escaped. He said, this is piety. Keeping away from all the prohibitions. Avoiding them if you have to. Not getting to them if you have to. Jumping over them if you have to. This is piety. But what salah does is, it brings piety. And piety is the key to Jannah. When we start the khutbah, what did we say? We recited the verse wherein Allah said, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqatih. Have piety as much as you can. Fear Allah as He ought to be feared. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Do not let the angel of death knock at your door until he finds you in a state wherein you are totally submissive to Allah. So salah introduces piety, taqwa, and every act of worship. All the 5 pillars is directing us towards piety. The Quran, Surah Baqarah, introduced piety. And the Quran can only benefit someone who has piety. Alif Lam Mim, Dhalikal Kitab, La Rayba Fi,
هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. This book, that book, لا ريب فيه. There is no doubt in this Quran. What is the Quran? هدى للمتقين is a guide. What is it? A guidance for those who have piety. Who are they? هدى للمتقين. Among the requirements of piety or being pious is that Allah mentioned وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ they establish salah وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ out of that which they have been blessed with, provided with, rizq, harje, warzaq, they give out to those that are deserving and are in need. So it leads to piety. Piety or righteousness is the prime objective which a Muslim has to achieve in this life. All the instructions, all the constraints, all the freedom, all the rights and education provided by Islam are with the objective that a Muslim becomes pious and moves to a righteous path. In this regard, prayer has a great role to play, as it promotes taqwa or piety. When it is said in the Quran, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب those who believe in the unseen ويقيمون الصلاة and they establish صلاة. Establishing صلاة means performing صلاة 5 times a day. Is that enough? No, it has to be on time. Is that enough? No, it has to be sincerely for the sake of Allah. Is that enough? No, it has to be with khushu, with devotion, concentration. Humble yourself for the sake of Allah. Then you start benefiting from the benefits of salah. The Prophet said, by performing only 2 rakats of salah with sincerity and devotion, doing it the way it has to be done, that fulfills the need of this world and the life hereafter. Just performing 2 rakats for the sake of Allah, it satisfies the need of this dunya and the life hereafter, so long as it is done the right way. No wonder Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ لَهُمْ عَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Indeed, those who believe and do righteous deeds and establish salam and give zakah will have their reward with their Lord, and there will be no fear concerning them, nor will they have any grief. Silangote mutala ni kuyate mutala nini mari man satalla lot ni lot nini mari man satalla e benyo yake ite silala kula and ite ni mesala kula e minke nun koma. So long as we believe in Allah and his Rasul and act righteously, therefore prayer is not something that ends in this world. It goes beyond dunya. Rather, the real reward for it will come or will surface when we stand before Allah Azza wa Jalla. Another benefit of salah is it prevents us from lewdness. Lewdness. Allah said in the Quran, Inna salata tanha anil fakhsha'i wal munkar. In life, a Muslim gets exposed to all sorts of environments and people. The Muslim gets exposed to all sorts of environments and people. Some of them whose behavior is not pleasing to Allah, but he still has to interact with them. He still has to be within the society, even though our norms and values sometimes might clash. But this is a Muslim for you, and this is dunya for you. There is no denying the fact that the current plight of people of this dunya is miserable, where they are more prone towards ill and lewdness, committing sins, than doing good. So being in the wrong avenue, being in the wrong society, mixing with the wrong people is more of the rule than it is the exception. But so long as we remember Allah, we will be guided and they will be guided. We don't have to avoid people. We have to mix with them and help them achieve goodness so that we can also have achieved goodness ourselves. Because the Prophet said, you cannot attain righteousness and piety until and unless what you love for yourself is what you love for your brother. لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. That's what Allah says in the Quran. You will not attain piety or righteousness until you give that which you love. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that to have true iman, you need to love for yourself what you love for your brother. So you need to love for your brother what you love for yourself. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. None of you will be a true believer until and unless what he loves for himself is the same thing that he loves for his brother, be it a Muslim or a non-Muslim. I'm a Muslim and I want the pleasure of Allah. That's the same thing I should love for a non-Muslim. So what can I do or say in order to encourage him, in order to have the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla? That's my responsibility. That's my duty. No wonder when the Prophet was questioned by the Sahabi, Ya Rasulullah, what's our role? What's our responsibility? He said, my job and my responsibility is your responsibility. And Allah empowered that in the Quran when he said, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Tell them, Muhammad, tell them, this is sabili, this is my way, this is my path, this is my responsibility, this is my job, this is my role. Adu'u ila Allah, calling people towards Allah. Ala basira, with basira. Ana wa mani taba'ani, this is my responsibility. Wa mani taba'ani, and whoever follows me. And he said, everyone will enter Jannah except those who deny. The Prophet said, everyone will enter Jannah, except those who said, you know what, we don't want to. And he was asked, وَمَنْ يَعْبَى يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, who are those who denied entering Jannah? He said, whoever follows me are the ones who want to enter Jannah. Whoever decides not to are the ones who deny. He didn't even say they are the ones going to Jahannam. He said they are the ones who deny. He is so kind. So kind-hearted. He didn't even mention that they're going to Jahannam. He said, they are the ones who deny. Everyone will enter Jannah except those who deny. Ya Rasulullah, who deny? Those who follow me will enter, and those who decide not to follow me are the ones who denied. Therefore, a Muslim must consider Salah as an effective weapon when it comes to fighting lewdness and all evils. Allah said in the Quran, أُتْلُ مَا أُوْحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. Allah said, recite, Muhammad, recite, recite what has been revealed to you of the book and establish salah. Establish salah. Perform salah on time with sincerity and devotion. That is what the establishment of salah means. Indeed, salah prohibits immorality and wrongdoing. Someone who is constant in praying 5 times a day, kasaloka watola famajio kang aning alanya silang kang dijuli chiwatu bole kogragal yalla atoroklu. What that does is it prohibits the individual from immorality and wrongdoing, and the remembrance of Allah is even greater, and Allah knows what you do. Wallahu wala dhikrullahi akbar wallahu ya'lamu ma tasnaun. Again, another good thing about salah is it is the best deed, the best action there is, according to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hazrat Abdullah ibn Mashhud, may Allah be pleased with him, said that he inquired of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, what was the best deed in the eyes of Allah, Ya Rasulullah? Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, to say the prescribed prayers on time, as-salatu ala waqtiha, performing salah on time. Performing salah on time. I'm at work, it's time to go to perform salah, stop everything and pray. I'm watching TV, it's time to perform salah, stop everything and pray. I'm engaged, I'm going somewhere else, let your life be centered around Islam. So before going out, the next thing you ask yourself is, when is the next salah, or is the next half an hour? Then I'm not leaving the house until I pray. Or I am going to the mosque, pray, then go to where I am going. Or wherever I am going, when it's time for prayers, I will perform salah. By so doing, you have centered your life around Islam. Not Islam, around your life. So that you do it when it suits you. It doesn't work out that way. Our life shouldn't be centered around Islam. Whatever Allah wants is done. Whatever we want is never a priority. Then we will be successful in this life and the life hereafter. So he asked the Prophet, what's the best deed? He said, As-salatu ala waqtiha, to perform salah on time. Then he asked him, what's the next best one? Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and I asked, what's the next one? He said, to be good to your parents. Birru walidayn. To be good to your parents. And he said, what's the next one? He said, striving in the path of Allah. Striving in that which is pleasing to Allah. Ibn Mas'ud said that if I had gone asking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he would have told me more and more. This is an authentic narration in Bukhari and Muslim. So the best action is performing salah. Not only limited to performing salah, but on time. And of course, for the main folk, within our local, at our local mosque. When you have a local mosque, you are a neighbor to the masjid. The 5 daily prayers should be performed in there. The Prophet never performed salah in his house. Even when he was ill, that was connected to his demise, he went and performed the congregational prayers with the support of 2 people holding either of both of his arms, just for him not to miss the Jama prayer. There was a day he said, I wish I can just ask someone to go and lead prayers. And I would ask the boys to go and collect firewood so that I can go and burn the individual in his own house who decides to pray without going to join the congregational prayer. The Prophet will never do that. But he's emphasizing how serious it is to pray at home when you have an opportunity to go to the mosque to perform the congregational prayer. Another thing, another benefit of salah is it brings salvation. Akamukis and the dunia jangkana fa yawmal qiyam dinga te adina al akhirah budé saxo nga julli ci waxtu bolé ko ragal yalla ak torokh. Hazrat Abdullah ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, said that one day the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was talking about prescribed prayers, and he said, whosoever is regular in his prayers at its time will illumine his face. Whoever is regular with salah, he will have a radiant face, a glowing one. Nyada mi yalonka beni norola. Kula jis rek hamna yangi andak leer. The Prophet said, whoever is regular with salah, this is one of the outcomes. And another one is, he testified to the firmness of his faith. Whoever is regular in performing salah 5 times a day, the Prophet said, testify to the firmness of his iman. Wala dankeniya wa bisabatrin mom yalla nko saliwato bukadan fama joni alanya sinonka wala dankeniya do sabatrin koku ngumam deguna ki nga xamne dafa saxo julli ci waxtu bolé ko ragal yalla ak torop. Again, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said the salah will be a cause of salvation for him on the day of qiyam. And whosoever neglect the prayer will neither acquire any glow nor staunchness of his faith, nor any means of salvation, and he will join on the day of resurrection the company of Qarun. Whoever is not mindful of his prayers, whoever neglects his salah, the Prophet said this individual will not have that glow, and that staunchness will not be with him. But besides, he will enjoy the companionship of Qarun and Fir'aun la'anatullah alayhi, and Haman, his chief minister, his prime minister. The prime minister of Fir'aun is Haman. The Prophet said, if you decide not to pray as a Muslim, if you neglect your salah, he will be your neighbor in Jahannam. Ubayy bin Qalaf. This is an authentic narration, brothers and sisters. It is a command from Allah that we should establish salah. May Allah guide us so that we can pray on time with sincerity and devotion. In our next khutbah, inshallah, we'll continue with the importance of salah. Allahumma hdina fi man hadayta.
وعافنا في من عافيت وتولنا في من توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا واشرف عنا شر ما قضيت فإنك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك إنه لا يذل من واليت ولا يئس من آديت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت نستغفرك من كل ذنب ونتوب إليك ونؤمن بك ونتوكل عليك ونثني عليك الخير كله يا من يجير ولا يجار عليه أجرنا من النار ومن خزي النار ومن كل عمل يقربنا إلى النار ودخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا جبار إن الله يعمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون وأقم الصلاة.